In order to understand the cause and effect of the evolving threat landscape, let us get into conversation with Mr. Vishak Raman, who is the Director of the Security Business at Cisco for India and SAARC. So hello and welcome, Vishak. Thank you for joining us today. How are enterprises really looking at visibility? And what are the challenges that they typically face in the process of looking at this, and how are they preparing themselves?
Very good starting point. If you really look at organizations' threat landscape, their infrastructure landscape has changed, and on three axes. The first one, the number of devices which is coming into the setup is huge. So the device proliferation is the biggest change. The second, the movement towards hybrid cloud, where your setup is no more in your north and southbound traffic, in your LAN, in your data center, but it's moved to a hybrid cloud workspace, and you need to get visibility. And the third most important part is you are not sitting anymore near the perimeter. Your perimeter is expanded a lot, where you have your partners, you have your customers, your network is actually, you know, sort of expanded. So devices, hybrid cloud adoption, and the expanding perimeter is rethinking and driving people to look at their threat landscape very, very differently.
So now that you've spoken about the changing threat landscape, how precisely has the threat landscape and the attack surface changed in enterprise IT environments?
Today, we are forced against newer protocols, your newer applications, which actually use a lot more P2P applications. You have advanced techniques which doesn't actually sort of get caught in the signature base. If you look at sleeping techniques, if you talk about exploits, if you look at the way environmental aware malwares are actually, you know, sort of going in. Today we are living in the world where you don't have a file. There's nothing called file-based malware. It is fileless malware, because all of it is going to run within the memory. So that's changed drastically from a attack techniques point of view.
Coming to the very next contextual question, what would be your main action points or recommendations for organizations, particularly in the large enterprise, to kind of take a look towards enhancing their visibility strategies as well as reducing their time to threat response?
Well, you touched upon a very important point. Visibility is on top of the mind, and first is to detect the detectable one. Start with basics, start with your crown jewels of basic net flow detection, which includes your switches, routers, your critical assets, and look for your net flow information and collect them. Second is, if you have invested in SIEM, enhance the SIEM and enrich the SIEM output. On the SOC side of automation, SIEM plays a very important piece, and you got to enrich your SIEM data, and it doesn't cost money. So that's the second point. And the third is to get deeper visibility across your setup.
So how is Cisco helping enterprise, its customers basically, to simplify this whole process?
If you look at it, what we propagate into customers is to not look at security in silos. Start looking at having an integrated view of your landscape across email, web, endpoint, proxy, and making sure you have your integration connectors built, and Cisco is doing that heavy lifting for you.
So what does strategic roadmap of Cisco as far as helping customers in security, where do we see the next 12 months going?
Well, we've made strategic investments. For example, in the last few years, Cisco has acquired technologies in identity access management, Duo security, in DNS security with our open DNS, and hybrid cloud security with observable networks, and the recent one we acquired, Centrio, which is pertaining towards IoT security. And we have stitched a common framework whereby you get best of the breed products. You want DNS security, you have standalone, but you still get the advantages of integration with your existing infrastructure. And with our leadership portion on the networking, it helps us to bring in those native net flows back to customers and correlate. And we've simplified the journey for customers and delivering the best of the breed security integrated with one single dashboard capability. So integration is the next driver for us, and simplification is important. Security need not be complex and need not be the most expensive one as well.
So wonderful insights. Thank you.
Thank you, Shantini.